Today, our activity will be you all taking smaller congruent shapes and building a larger, similar shape.
Teacher Tom Wolken worked in the computer industry before coming to teach 7th grade math at Olmsted North. And the career change culture shock caused him to be physically ill and mentally stressed.
Within the first week that I was here, I approached my principal, Mr. Perkins, and I told him that I was having a really bad day. He said, how bad could it get? I described the worst situation would be that I went back to my former employer and they had already filled my position. And I was jingling my car keys as I said this to him. So he said, well, we'll get you some more help in your classroom. You hang in there and give me another week. And I did that, and I've had every year since then, it's gotten better and better.
Which of these shapes can fit together to make a larger shape that's similar to the original?
Now, 3 years into the job, Wolken's classroom is a hive of active learning, partly because he's learned some tricks of the trade in dealing with Olmsted's all-male environment.
In my 3 years of teaching, I've only taught all boys. So I like that energy in the classroom.
Okay. You have 20 seconds when I say go.
We can be more competitive. Boys respond to a competitive environment. I'd like to time my classroom, a lot of things we do.
Joan, there's 19 seconds left. We need to
boys respond to different colors and sound cues than girls do. So I try to use all that in my classroom environment to get my boys engaged and keep them learning.
Divide up the work. Have one person work on squares and sketch it. One person work on diamonds.
I could have done this lesson 3 years ago, but I don't think the student outcomes would have been as good. I wouldn't have been cued into the boys' energy. I probably would have stood and lectured most of the time instead of having them do hands-on activities. I probably would not have given them as much structure. Boys need structure.
Give you guys 10 more seconds.
These are the outcomes that we're expecting. This is the time that you have to do it in. You're gonna have time to work together, then you're gonna have time to listen to your instructor. And during that time, you'll also be asking questions, but we raise our hands, we don't shout out. So it brought a lot of different structure and energy to my classroom that was not there 3 years ago.
Now remember, let's think about using our math words.
I created a PowerPoint display to put up a special message during the week. It's usually an inspirational message. I also use the clock to show pictures of the students doing things that demonstrate school spirit or having fun. It's also classroom management because I'll tell my guys that if they earn recognition slips in my room, that I can put their picture and two of their buddies up on TV for a week, and they get excited about that.
Quantel's gonna show us how he did his trapezoid.
I use the webcam in my classroom for two reasons. First, the boys respond to be able to show and demonstrate their work. They take a great deal of pride in that. And secondly, I use it as a classroom management tool. I went out and spent $20 at the discount store. The camera is mounted on popsicle sticks with duct tape, and it gives the boys an area where they can show their work.
So Dwan created a larger version of that triangle.
As far as classroom management, I use the camera because if the boys want to come up and use it, they need to show me that they've gotten their work done. They need to have had appropriate behavior during the lesson, and then they're eligible to come up and use the technology. So it's not just a whiz-bang feature in the classroom, it's also for their learning experience, because if everybody's doing their work, if everybody's being respectful in the classroom, then everybody can learn.
What was our scale factor to go from 1 to 2 inches?
2 inches. Okay. For more information about what works in public education, go to edutopia.org.